Let us continue the session. I told you a power 5, we obtained a power 5 is equal to 4 a power 4 minus 7 a cube. So I should find a power 4 and I have to find a cube. Multiply that a power 4 by 4, multiply that a cube by minus 7, and then add in the two matrix, that will give you a power 5 matrix. So listen, a power 4, how to obtain a power 4? You have three cases. It can be a cube into a, or a into a cube, or a square into a square. As we already have a square, let us go ahead with a square into a square. So if we say a square into a square, already we found that a square matrix, you can substitute that. So a square matrix into a square matrix, it is just a matrix multiplication. Already we have done enough problems based on matrix multiplication. You can cross check the resultant matrix over there. It is by row in the column, first one in the second column, as usual for the second one. Now a cube. A cube is a matrix which is obtained by a square into a, the product of matrix a square and a. This is a square matrix which we have already formed into matrix a. Multiply the two matrix, that will give you the matrix a cube. Now according to this a power 5 should be equal to 4 a power 4 minus 7 a cube, which means 4 into multiply to each and every element of the matrix. There we have the resultant matrix here. This is nothing but 4 a power 4. Listen carefully, if we say 4 a power 4, I should multiply that 4 to each and every element of the matrix. This is the resultant matrix for a power 4. Now similarly, minus 7 to a cube. So I have to multiply this minus 7 to each and every element of the a cube matrix. I have to multiply this minus 7 to each and every element of a cube matrix. The resultant matrix has been placed here. Now adding the two matrix. Adding the two matrix, which is nothing but matrix a power 5. Just add the two matrix, that will give you the matrix a power 5. As I already told you, it is an important homework question. Now listen. Question number 14. If matrix A is given and they say I is the identity matrix of order 3, I is the identity matrix of order 3, I have to verify this result. I have to prove that A cube, that is equal to BI plus QA plus RA square. So I have to verify this result. So first I will start A square. First I need to find A square. Of course we know what is A square. A square means it is product of A matrix and A matrix. So A square is, I have just placed A matrix and A matrix and I have done the matrix multiplication here. For example, first element into first element plus second element into third element into third element, adding the product, that will give you 0. Because 0 into 0 plus 1 into 0 plus 0 into 3, that is equal to 0. Similarly, second row, first row into second column. First row into second column is 0 into 1 plus 1 into 0 plus 0 into 2. So that is also 0. Similarly, first row into third column, 0 into 0 plus 1 into 1 plus 0 into r. That is nothing but 1. So 0 plus 1 plus 0, that is equal to 1. Do the same process for second row and the third row. Second row into first column, second row into second column, second row into third column, and you stop in row plus second row. And similarly, third row into first column, third row into second, and third row into third column. And then add in the product, that will give you 2 plus r square. Now, my actual left hand side is a cube. A cube is my left hand side. So how will I obtain an a cube? I already told you a cube, we have two cases, either you can multiply a and a square or a square and a. Both are correct, both are same. So here I have done a cube equal to a square into a. The a square matrix we have already formed, just place it. And a matrix is a given matrix, just place it. Now do the matrix multiplication. As usual, row into first column, first row into second column. I mean the corresponding elements of first row into the corresponding elements of second column, and the elements of first row and multiply to the corresponding elements of third column, adding the product. Similarly, I should be like matrix. See here, third row into first column. Third row into first column means this first element into 0 is 0, plus p plus r q into 0, plus q plus r square into p. What is q plus r square into p? This p q plus p r square. That is p q plus p r square. Similarly, third row into second column, which means p r into 1, which is p r, plus p plus r q into 0. P plus r q into 0 is 0. Then q plus r square into q, which is q square plus q r square. Similarly, third row into third column, that will give you this element. Third row into third column will give you this element. Please take the same. So we have obtained the left hand side matrix to keep as first equation. Now listen, for to obtain the RHS, I have to show that A cube is equal to sum of these three matrix. So let me take PA matrix first. What is the PA? P into the identity matrix of order 3. P into identity matrix of order 3. So which means P into 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. That is equal to P 0 0 0 P 0 0 0 P. As we know, we have to multiply each and every element of the matrix. Similarly, QA. Q into A matrix. So there we have A matrix here. Q into A matrix means I should multiply the Q to each and every element of the matrix. I have to multiply Q to each and every element of the matrix. That will give you this matrix. I have already written the matrix here. Now, the third matrix is R into A square. R into A square. Already we know what is A square. We have already obtained A square. R into A square means I should multiply R to each and every element of A square. Multiply R to each and every element of A square. You will obtain this matrix. Now, right answer is nothing but the addition of these three matrix. Just add the three matrix. If we say add the three matrix, you should add the corresponding element of the three matrix. You have to add the corresponding elements. Means this first element plus first element plus first element, which is nothing but P. Similarly, second element plus second element plus second element, which is nothing but Q. And third element plus third element plus third element, that will give you R. Similarly, add the corresponding elements 0 plus 0 plus PR, which means it is PR. Then P plus 0 plus QR, which means P plus QR. And similarly, I used to obtain the exact matrix, you can cross check the same. By adding the corresponding elements, you can check whether this matrix is equal to this or not. Definitely, they will be equal because it is a proving sum. Okay, we need to prove LHS is equal to RHS. PQ plus PR square, you can add the and check the corresponding elements. This is PR plus Q square plus QR square, and P plus 2RQ plus RQ. This is equation number 2. Therefore, I can conclude 1 is equal to 2. So, LHS equal to RHS. LHS equal to RHS. Now question number 15. If capital A equal to cos theta minus sin theta, then sin theta cos theta, find theta satisfying, find theta will satisfy the equation which satisfies the matrix equation A plus A bar B equal to I2. If I say I2, it is a identity matrix of order 2. If I say I2, it is a identity matrix of order 2. See here, they said A plus A bar B. A bar B means transpose of the matrix, which means columns into rows and rows into columns. So now I can say matrix A is cos theta minus sin theta, sin theta cos theta, plus the transpose of the matrix is transpose means rows into columns and columns into rows. So cos theta, first column should be written as first row and second column should be written in the second row, sin theta cos theta, that is equal to I2 means identity matrix of order 2. Now add the corresponding elements. If you add the corresponding elements, therefore it is 2 cos theta 0 0 and 2 cos theta, that is equal to 1 0 0 1. Now listen, when the two matrices are equal, which implies their corresponding elements are equal, so I can say 2 cos theta equal to 1. So cos theta equal to 1 by 2. Cos theta equal to 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 I have to write it as cos of which angle is 1 by 2? Cos of pi by 3. We know that cos pi by 3 equal to 1 by 2. Now we have to get the general solution of this. When I say cos x equal to cos pi, what is the general solution? X equal to 2n pi plus or minus pi by n denominator. So I can say theta equal to 2n pi plus or minus pi by 3, where n belongs to 0. This is my general solution. This can be tested in 2 mark. Question number 16. If pi is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1 and E equal to 0, 1, 0, 0. True then? A I plus B E, the whole cube, that is equal to A Q I plus C A square B E. I have to do the 3 A square B E. This is also a very simple question. I have to verify LHS equal to RHS. For that I have to do in steps. First I need to find AI plus DE. Then I cannot find directly the Q. I have to find out the square of that first and then follow the Q. I have to go in steps. So first step is I should find out AI plus DE. AI plus DE, which means A into identity matrix. So it is going to be A 0, 0 A plus B E means B into matrix E. If we say B into matrix E, I should multiply this B to each and every element of matrix E. That is 0, B, 0, 0. So this will give you A, B, 0, A. A, B, 0, A. Now listen, I should find out AI plus BE the whole square. AI plus BE the whole square. If I say the whole square, I have to do the matrix multiplication, which is nothing but AI plus BE. This is my, this matrix is AI plus BE into AI plus BE. We know that AI plus BE is AB 0A. So it is AB 0A. I have to do this matrix multiplication. Of course, first row into first column. It is A square plus 0, which is nothing but A square. Now, first row into second column. It is AB plus AB, which is nothing but 2AB. Now, second row into first column. It is 0 plus 0. Now, second row into second column. It is 0 plus A square. So, this is my Now what is the next step? In the first step we formed AI plus BE. In step number 2 we formed AI plus BE the whole square. Now the actual LHS is, what is my left hand side? AI plus BE the whole cube. This is my left hand side. AI plus BE the whole cube is my left hand side. I told you if I say whole cube, it can be either square into power 1 or power 1 into square. Anything is acceptable, isn't it? So first square, this is AI plus BE the whole square into AI plus BE, which is AB0K. Now once again match multiplication. This will give you A cube plus 0, which is A cube. Now first row in the second column is A square B plus 2A square B. So A square into B, A square B plus 2A square into B, which means I can directly say it's 3A square into B. Now 0 plus 0, which is nothing but 0. Then once again 0 will be 0 plus A square B is A cube. So let us keep it as equation number 1. I got the left hand side. Now in for right hand side I have 3 steps. First I should find A cube into I. Then I have to find 3A square B into E. Then I should add the two matrix. Fine. So first what is A cube into I? Let us find out A cube into I, which means A cube into 1 0 0 1. This is nothing but A cube 0 0 A cube. And then followed by 3 A square B into E matrix, which means 3 A square B into matrix E is, what is matrix E? Matrix E is 0 1 0 0. So 0 1 0 0. That is equal to 0 3 A square B and 0 0. Now I need to add the two matrix. It's very simple. Now the RHS. Now my right hand side is nothing, right? I should add the two matrix A cube I and 3 A square B into E. Just add the two matrix. If we say add the two matrix, add the corresponding elements. I should add the corresponding elements. This is A cube and 3 A square B and 0 A cube. The same thing we have in equation number 1. So I can directly say 1 is equal to 2. So LHS is equal to RHS. We can say LHS is equal to RHS and we have verified the same. Now question number 16. If capital A equal to
is it?
part t into A. We know that A part t, I should place A part t matrix first. A part t into A. I have to place A part t matrix first. That is equal to 9 IP. If I say 9 IP, it is 9 into identity matrix. 9 0 0 0 9 0 0 0 9. Something like this. And A part E is 1 2 A. This first column to be written in the first row. And second column to be written in the second row, which means 2 and 2. And third column should be written in the third row. Now into matrix A. Into matrix A is 1 2 2. Now, the product of these two matrix is the identity matrix multiplied by 9, which means 9 0 0 0 9 0 0 0 9. Now, do the matrix multiplication. See here, first row into first column, that will give you 1 plus 4 plus a square. Now, first row into second column, which means 2 plus 2 plus 2a. 2 plus 2 plus 2a. Am I right? Now first row into third column, which means 2 minus 4, 2 minus 4 plus AB, 2 minus 4 plus AB. Now I have to do the same work for second row. Second row, the elements of second row to be multiplied to the corresponding elements of first column, which means 2 plus 2 plus 2A, 2 plus 2 plus 2A. Now similarly, 4 plus 1 plus 4. 4 plus 1 plus 4. Now 4 minus 2 plus 3. Now third row in first column. 2 minus 4 plus AB. Now third row in second column, which means 4 minus 2 plus 2B. Now third row in third column, which is 4 plus 4 plus B square. 4 plus 4 plus B square. That is equal to 9 0 0 0 9 0 0 0 9. So listen, this is nothing but 5 plus a square, 4 plus 4 a, minus 2 plus a b. Similarly, 4 plus 2 a, 9, 2 plus 2 b.
Exactly.
satisfies the corresponding second element, also the corresponding first element. So A equal to minus 2 is the only solution, and B equal to minus 1. Let's start the next question. Question number 17. Sum number 17. If A equal to 2 minus 1, 3, 4, and B equals 5, 2, 7, 4. B equals 5274 and C equals 2538. Find the matrix D. Find the matrix D such that CD minus AB that is equal to matrix O means 0 matrix. CD minus AB equal to 0 matrix. So listen, they say matrix multiplication is defined C into D minus A into D, which means CD equal to AB. Now I can say CD equal to AB matrix, which means the matrix D should be of order, because look at this, what is the order of A and B? The order of A is 2 cross 2 and B is also 2 cross 2. So the resultant order is also 2 cross 2. Similarly, the order of C matrix is 2 cross 2. Then what should be the order for matrix D? Which implies the order of matrix D must be two cross two. See here, the number of rows should be two. Of course, then only CD is defined, and the number of columns is also two because the resultant order is also 2 cross 2. Since the resultant order is 2 cross 2, the matrix D should be of order 2 cross 2. No doubt about that. So let us assume the D matrix as, let us take the matrix D as A, B, C, D. Now C into D matrix, which means place the matrix C into D matrix. D matrix is A, B, C, D. That is equal to A into D, which means 2 minus 1, 3, 4 into 5274. Now matrix multiplication once again, it implies 2A plus 5C. 2A plus 5C is the first element, and 2B plus 5B is going to be the second element. And similarly, second row, the first column is 3A plus 8C, and this is going to be 3B plus 8D. That is equal to 10 minus 7, 3. 4 minus 4, 0. 15 plus 28. 15 plus 28. 40. Then 6 plus 16. 22. Which implies, once again, the two matrices are equal to their corresponding elements are equal. So I can say 2a plus 5c equal to 3. And 3a plus 8c, corresponding element, equal to 42. And similarly, that's e by the corresponding second element, 5b plus 3 equals 0. And 3b plus 8d equal to 22. Now, solving the above, we use the way we get the values of a, b, c, d as we get a equal to 191 is minus 110, C is 77 and D is 44. Now the actual question is find the matrix D, so you have to write the matrix D by placing all the elements in A, B, C, D. Therefore, the matrix D equal to, you have to write this matrix D equal to minus 191, minus 110, 77, 44. Can you copy the same? This is the end of the session. Thank you.